Goodwill Community Foundation, creating opportunities for a better life.
Outlook 2010 includes a calendar feature that you can use to schedule appointments and manage your time. In this video, we're going to go over the basics of working in Calendar View. To get started, make sure you have Calendar selected in the lower left corner. In the View pane, you should see something that looks like a calendar or a weekly planner. Right now, mine is showing the full week, but I can change it to show a single day, the work week, or the entire month. You can also use the forward and back arrows to change the date range that you're looking at. If you're viewing a single day or week, then you can use the small calendar on the left side to select which day or week that you want to look at. If you look carefully, you'll notice that some of the dates are in bold, and those are the dates that have at least one appointment scheduled. No matter which day you're viewing, you can jump back to today's date by clicking the Today command. Let's add an appointment to the calendar. Click and drag to select the time range that you want, and then right-click and select New Appointment. Then you can type the subject, which is the name of the appointment, and you can also type a location, but this isn't required. Before we save this, there are a couple of options that we have. By default, it's going to remind you 15 minutes before the appointment happens, but if you need more time to get ready, you can choose an earlier reminder. If this appointment is going to repeat, say every week, then you'll need to click the Recurrence button. Then you can choose how often you want it to repeat and when you want it to repeat. This is going to occur every Wednesday. Then you can click OK. Just like an email, you can add a category to your appointment. And when you're done, you can click Save and Close. Now, if I switch to Month View, you can see that it's scheduled this appointment for every Wednesday. Sometimes you may have an event that lasts two or more days, and you'll need to create a multiple-day appointment. For example, let's say I'm going to be out of town from Thursday through Monday. This time, I'm going to create an appointment by just double-clicking anywhere on Thursday's schedule. For this appointment, we don't need a specific time, so you can select All Day Event. Then you'll need to adjust the end time by clicking the drop-down arrow and selecting the date that you want. Make sure to type a subject. And in this case, the location isn't important, so we'll save and close. Now, when we switch to Month View, you can see that the appointment goes from Thursday through Monday. If you have a lot of different appointments, you can use multiple calendars to help organize everything. For example, I'd like to create a separate calendar that just shows my meetings with clients. To create a new calendar, click the Folder tab, and then select New Calendar. Then type a name for the calendar, and select the location. I'm going to keep this inside the Main Calendar folder. Then click OK. On the left side of the screen, under My Calendars, you'll see a list of all of your calendars. You can click each checkbox to turn each calendar on and off. You can either view them side by side, or just one at a time. So those are the basics of working with calendars in Outlook 2010.